How does it feel to be a Christian in New York City?
Yeah, that's such a good question, Anthony. It feels great. I love being a person of faith, a woman of faith in a city like New York. Mm-hmm. The reason why I moved to New York, a huge reason. So, you know, I go from Bible major to graduating. I went into the nonprofit world and then got into the photography world, started my own editorial photography business, moved to New York to be an editorial photographer. So that's kind of a little bit of how the breadcrumbs of how I got to New York.
Okay.
But I was so excited to leave the bubble of Christian culture in the South.
Mm.
And, you know, there's a theologian and philosopher, Kierkegaard, and he calls it like the crowd Christian, or mm-hmm. it's like the, where everyone's a Christian, no one's a Christian. And even though I didn't grow up in a Christian home, Christianity was the air I breathed. That scent when you walk into your parents' house that you don't know your parents' house smells like something until you leave and come back. And you're like, oh, what is that? And then you're there for a few seconds and then it just disappears because you're used to it again. I didn't realize how much of a bubble I was in. I was at a Christian school. I worked at a church, and then I moved to Southern California right after college, which Orange County, California is the second Bible Belt. So people would be like, wow, you moved to California. It's so liberal there. And I was like, this is the most Republican, conservative, white place I've ever lived in.
Oh,
and
man.
So really for me, moving to New York was this resolve that I had to really get outside of my comfort zone.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I had this picture that New York City is sort of this pulse, this heartbeat of Western culture.
Mm.
It's where the best of the best of the best in the U.S. go, at least. So, you know, that's the epicenter of the finance world. It's the epicenter of the fashion industry, which is the industry I was in at the time. And I just felt, I believed still that, you know, if you can make an impact to the influencers, if you can influence the influencers, that influence is going to pulsate throughout our entire culture.
Yeah.
So for me, going to New York was exciting to finally be like, I want to be a minority in my worldview.
Wow.
Because really that's like, the world isn't Christian.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah.
And America isn't quote unquote Christian. And also Jesus lived this life where he was constantly surrounded by people who didn't believe what he believed, who would never step foot inside a church. And so I just felt like, man, I want my life to be reflective of the life of Jesus.
Mm.
And so if the only people I hang out with believe what I believe, talk like I talk, dress like I dress, then I am really living a lot more like the Pharisees or the religious elite as opposed to the life of Jesus. So I think that felt exciting. And then also to be a Christian in New York is hard. It's not convenient.
Now, I was just about to ask you that. You saying you love it.
Mm-hmm.
But how is it hard in New York? And I want to ask you two questions. Is it hard to be a Christian in New York? And is it hard to live below your means in New York?
I
need to know both of those questions.
Yes.
So like, can you do both? Or can you only do one? Or can you not do either? What's your honest opinion to those two questions?
Yeah. Well, I think to be a human in New York City is a hard thing. It's not whatever you believe about life or God, you are thrust into this city where there's very little greenery.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of frenetic energy. There's taxi cabs at all hours of the day. There's in New York City, you are what you do. So, you know, working 100-hour work weeks is glorified. Everyone has their job and then their side hustle and then their investments on the side. And so I think what felt hard for me about being a Christian was I moved to New York City and didn't realize all of these sort of narratives I had grown up believing because Christianity was cultural, like Christians don't have sex outside of marriage. Good Christians don't live with their boyfriends if they're not married. And then I moved to New York where no one knows the quote unquote rules because it's not the culture.
Come on.
And so I'm in small groups at church and girls are talking about how they're sleeping around, having casual sex, and part of that was refreshing because people are having sex and sleeping around wherever you live. But in the South or the Southern Christian culture that I grew up in, you didn't talk about it.
You're right. Right.
You know, and so I felt like, oh, wait, is this really what God wants us to do? Or is this some sort of antiquated Christian norm that's no longer relevant? Mm. So really the hard parts of it are really what caused me to press into God and seek the scriptures of, what is it that I really believe? And what does the scriptures really say versus what are sound bites that I have received as gospel truth?
Wow.
So doing the work of unpacking what does scripture really say was hard and is hard. But I think growth happens as soon as we step outside of our comfort zone.
What? Say that again. say that again.
Hold on.
Say it again. What did you just say?
Growth happens the moment we step outside of our comfort zone.
Y'all have heard that before on this show. What do I say? You have to be willing to step outside your comfort zone because nothing extraordinary comes from within inside your comfort zone.
Yes.
And Kat, who is sexless in the great city of New York City, just said she had to step outside of her comfort zone.
That's right. Ooh. So it's easy not to have sex when you live in a culture that shames sex outside of marriage.
Oh.
It's easy to have certain political beliefs when everyone and their mom believes a certain thing.
Kat, you talking.
It's easy to have thoughts about LGBTQ community when you have no one in your life that identifies as LGBTQ.
Yes.
So stepping outside of your house, your apartment, your tiny rat-infested apartment in New York City every single day, I'm sitting on a subway next to a CEO, a homeless person, a Hasidic Jewish man who my very existence is immodest and sinful. and every single day I'm collided with humanity. Yeah. So is it hard?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
But I think that it is so important to put myself in hard circumstances.
No, absolutely.
And in uncomfortable circumstances.
Kat, you listen, Kat. You preaching my stuff on my show, and you've never been on my show before. Thank you so, so, so much.